Hello folks, so what I want to do in this video is to talk a little bit about the NAND array. That is, how are these different flash memory cells connected together in an array. And I also want you to understand this term that you often see in news. So there's a new news article from SanDisk announcing their 19 nanometer memory. So when they say 19 nanometer, they say this is produced using this 19 nanometer manufacturing technology. And this article claims that this is the world's smallest chip at that particular time, and it's based on this 19 nanometer technology. So when they say this 19 nanometer technology, what does it mean? Does it mean that their cell is size 19 nanometer by 19 nanometer? Does it mean that this is the distance between two word lines? Or does it mean that this is the distance between two bit lines? So we want to answer these questions also when we look at this NAND array. So let's look at you know, what do you mean by a NAND array. So array means there will be bit lines and there will be word lines, and that would form your NAND array. And so what you do first is you define your bit lines. That's how a NAND array is defined. You first define these bit lines, and these are essentially running parallel to each other, and they are etched into your silicon. So this blue thing represents silicon over here, and they are etched into your silicon, and they are separated from each other using this shallow trench isolation. So these bit lines are separated using shallow trench isolation. And then what we do is we come on top of, when we have formed these bit lines, we form these word lines which run perpendicular to these bit lines, essentially what you call as your control gate. So these would be your control gates running in this particular perpendicular direction to your bit lines. And now we have essentially an array, and suppose we want to address one particular cell. We select, say, bit line 1, and we select all the transistors on this on the other bit line such that they turn on, and we select this particular word line, and that would select this particular flash memory cell. So at the cross section of each of these bit lines and word line, there's a flash memory cell. So there's a flash memory cell over here. If you see a bit line N, and this would be, say, word line 3, so intersection of these would have a flash memory cell, and each of these will essentially look something like this. So it would look something like this. So you'll have your silicon from your bit line, and you'll have this control gate which will be forming your word line, and in between you'll be having this floating gate into which you can store charge and erase charge, and that way you can control the state of that cell. So when we look at this flash memory array, again it's a intersection of these intertwining bit lines and word lines. So it's important to look along different directions. We want to look at how does this array look along this direction, how does this direction, meaning the direction around the bit line, and then how does this array look along this direction, that is the direction along my word line. So let's look at a few cross sections. First, I want to show you a cross section along the bit line. So shown here is a cross section along the bit line. So if you look at this array along the bit line, so these blue colored lines are my bit lines, and I'm taking a cross section over here. So what I immediately realize is this cross section, I'll have these multiple transistors which are connected, flash memory cells which are connected in series. So what I expect is essentially these each of these flash memory cells, and I denote flash memory cell by this symbol. So there's a floating gate and there's this control gate. So each of these flash memory cell is connected in series with each other. So shown here is another picture which shows the same thing. So it shows these different flash memory cell which are connected in a NAND string. So this is one flash memory cell, and this is another flash memory cell, this is another flash memory cell, and they are sharing these junctions between each other. So this is a common source or drain between these two cells, and this is a common source to drain between these cells. And this is how it would look like if I take a cross section over here. And in fact, this is showing actual cross section along these NAND of these NAND array along the bit line direction. So again, you can identify these transistors, these flash memory cell. So another important point that I want to make is these alternate transistors, or these adjacent transistors along my bit line. They can very well be separated or placed very closely. So this distance between these two transistors on a particular bit line could be as low as the feature size. So let's say if your feature size is 90 nanometer, this distance can in fact be 90 nanometer. And these cross section along of these cells could be 90 nanometer as well. So when we saw that announcement from Sandisk saying that their technology is 90 nanometer, it is very well possible that these lines would have been placed 90 nanometer apart from each other. So whenever we look at these cross sections of an array, it's important to look at both directions. So I show you the cross section around bit line direction, but it's also important to look at the cross section perpendicular to it, that is the direction of my word line. So I'm showing you a cross section along the word line. So as I mentioned, these different word lines are etched into the silicon. So these different bit lines are etched into my silicon. So this would be my bit line 1, and this would be my bit line 2, and then they are separated from each other using this shallow trench isolation. So you can clearly see this trench which is separating my alternating bit lines, and it's etched into the silicon, and then it's filled up with an oxide layer. And this trench has a very high aspect ratio. It's 270 nanometer deep, and these different bit lines, you know, so this distance could be anywhere between say 30 nanometer. So this has a very high aspect ratio. And then you can see this word line which is wrapping on top of these different cells. So this is a cross section along my word line. So I see this word line wrapping on the top. And let me take a further zoomed in view and look into how the transistors along the word line look like. So now I have completed forming my cell, and I have these different bit lines, and I can see them over here. So this is my bit line, this could be my bit line 1, this could be my bit line 2, and these are made etched into my silicon, and then they are separated by this shallow trench isolation. So I can still see the upper part of this shallow trench isolation which is separating these adjacent cells. And then I can see over here my floating gate. So this is my floating gate. But the interesting part is now that my word line, so this is my word line. So my word line is wrapping around my cell. So what I see is my word line is wrapping around my cell. So what I see over here, so this is the floating gate, and then you have this O and O stack. So you can let me label it over here. So this is your floating gate, and this is your interpoly dielectric, this is your tunnel dielectric, and this interpoly dielectric consists of this O NO, and you can see the contrast difference between them. So this would be your oxide, then you have a nitride and your oxide, and then you have this word line, which is in this case made of polysilicon. And you see your word line and this ONO or your IPD, it's wrapping around your floating gate cell. So the reason why it is done so is because you want to increase your coupling between your floating gate and your control gate. So if you wrap it, if you have a floating gate and then you wrap around your control gate, so it gets, you surround it along three directions instead of just one. So you get higher capacitance with your control gate. And our GCR, or gate coupling ratio, which is a key term, which is defined by this coupling that you get with your control gate divided by the total capacitance of your floating gate. So that stays high because now you are getting higher capacitance with this control gate. So that's the reason we do this wrap around. And shown here is another picture which shows just zoomed in view of this one of these transistors and along the word line direction. So you can see that this is my floating gate. And so, and this is my tunnel oxide, and this is my O, this is my N, and O labeled over here as ONO as well. And both my interpoly dielectric and my control gate is wrapping around my my floating gate, and that is intentionally done to increase my gate coupling ratio. So this helps in improving our gate coupling ratio, but it comes with two disadvantages. The first disadvantage that I want to mention is that your IPD, or this interpoly dielectric, will have certain thickness. So in this case, as you can see, this IPD has a thickness of, let's say, 12 nanometer. So, and if I'm wrapping around this IPD around my two cells, the distance between my cell has to be at least these two IPD thickness. So there has to be at least 12 times 2 distance separating over here. So this distance has to be greater than at least twice of my thickness of my interpoly dielectric for this to wrap around my floating gate. So this distance is typically larger. The distance between two adjacent bit lines has to be at least twice more than the IPD thickness. So this distance is typically, in the range of anywhere between, 26 to 30, 35 kind of nanometer range. And this distance between the word line we saw can be actually smaller because it does not involve a lap around. And this could be, in fact, around 90 nanometer. So this is one of the disadvantage of doing this wrap around of my control gate. We have another disadvantage that you get in terms of scaling that I'll talk in the next video. But the next time somebody, you meet somebody from SanDisk or Micron or Samsung or Intel, and then they say, we have launched this technology which is 15 nanometer, and then you can say to him, do you mean 15 nanometer along between two word lines, or do you mean 15 nanometer between two bit lines? And you can say, I don't think so, it's 15 nanometer, and you can tell him why, and maybe you can have a intelligent conversation over a cup of coffee with him.